The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment, heard on the official website of HEW Entertainment. It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beast! The Man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio, on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
What we gotta do right here is go back. Back in the time.
Something, want it all the time, need it every day. Honestly, I don't want to tell. fine, make you feel so fine. I hope you hit me on my celly when I sneak in your mind. You a princess to the public, but a freak when it's time. Said you better be feeling lonely, so you sleeping in mine. Come and watch a movie with me. American Beauty or Bruce Almighty, that's groovy. Just come and move closer to me. I got some feelings for you, I'm not gonna get bored of. But baby, you an adventure, so let me come and explore ya.
Yeah. Baby, you got me. I got a bad boy, I must admit it. You got my heart, don't know how you did it. And I don't care the taste of paper, but I wanna know the way I feel when you're next to me. I know the way, 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 I know the way.
Featuring Mac Miller, it's called The Way. If you revert back to 1 year ago, one thing that I was consistently saying was that Ariana Grande was going to be something big. She had a prominent future and a successful one at that, and that single, which is already on the top 40 of Billboard chart, is a surefire indication that Ariana Grande has yet to see the best years of her career. We have joined our conversation for you on Facebook. We did it a while ago, facebook.com/Ariana Grande, and we are also following her presently for you on Twitter. Amongst the thousands of celebrities we are currently following for you at Ariana Grande, she is diligently promoting her single The Way, which is receiving millions of hits on both Vevo and YouTube, and deservingly so. Prominent future yet to be seen by all of our fans. Ariana Grande, it's called The Way, featuring Mac Miller. In addition to seeing the music video as one of our featured videos at the bottom of our radio form, you can view it on Twitter at JonathanClark1, and we are inviting you to subscribe and follow us and tell us what you think of the single. Do you want us to keep playing it as part of our playlist on this radio show, or kill it in its entirety? I like the presentation and feel of the song, and I think for months to come you're going to hear it as part of our playlist. If I had to make a judgment call, an analogy of this single, because I said a year ago Ariana Grande had a prominent future, and that single is the first sign of prominent years and successful ones at that to come from Ariana Grande. So with that being said, yes, there is more to talk about than Justin Bieber and Selena Gomez getting back together, because Ariana Grande is something to talk about, and also Taylor Swift receiving Artist of the Year at the 2013 Billboard Music Awards was absolutely phenomenal. It was one of the highlights of the night, and her reaction to winning the award is an image that has been instilled in the minds of Taylor Swift fans and will be talked about for many years to come. When Taylor Swift wins an award, the overwhelming response and reaction that she gets is something that is always talked about. I go back to when she won the Entertainer of the Year Award at the Country Music Association Awards a couple of years ago, when she was presented the award by Ryan Seacrest. After all the promotion that she gives for an album or a project that she is doing, even the smallest things going on in her career that she promotes on her Facebook page and on her Twitter, she is awarded for all the work and all the diligence that she exemplifies. In this award that she recently won at the 2013 Billboard Music Awards, is an indication of just how much work ethic and how diligent she is with everything. Her album Red, which you can download from iTunes after purchasing an iTunes card, it is really worth the full price of the album, because every single on the album I love. Even the slow songs have something special about them. It refers to a certain person in Taylor Swift's life on every track. Every single, like We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together in 22, has premiered somewhere on the Billboard charts. Slowly but surely, 22 is climbing to the top position. We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together has already made it as a number one single from Taylor Swift. She has recorded and produced more number one hits than any young artist that pertains to teens or a certain age demographic. And why not make her Artist of the Year? Congratulations to Taylor Swift for winning that award. Her speech that she gave at the 2013 Billboard Music Awards can be viewed on our Twitter at JonathanClark1. It is presently one of our featured videos at the bottom of our radio form, and the speech that she gave was a very detailed speech. She thanked a number of different people for making it possible for her, and especially her fans, for voting for her for 2013 Artist of the Year. What is next for Taylor Swift? She has won virtually every award that she has been eligible to qualify for and win. She has been nominated in endless numbers of categories through the years. She hasn't won every award she's been nominated for, but pretty close to it. And this album, Red, has got to be one of her most successful. And the next album that premieres from Taylor Swift is probably going to be double the amount of success that we have seen from Red. It is a phenomenal album, and it is the one album from Taylor Swift that has more number one singles and eligible number one singles than any album previously released from Taylor Swift. She released her first album back in 2008. And putting it into perspective for you, this album has sold more copies than any previous Taylor Swift album and has more eligible number one singles than any album that has ever been created from Taylor Swift. You know, her first number one singles, of course, Tim McGraw and Teardrops on My Guitar, were a surefire indication that Taylor Swift had many years of success ahead for her, and she was looked at as one of the most prominent individuals in the country music industry. She crossed over from country to pop very successfully. She made a number of different remixes from some of her country-related singles, and then she started coming out with albums that referred to different people in her life, mainly the people she was involved in relationships with through the years, like John Mayer, Jake Gyllenhaal from The Prince of Persia, that very successful Disney movie. And she went from doing those singles on her first few albums to releasing singles pertaining to people in her life that she was involved in relationships with mainly, and those singles surprisingly brought her the most success. And she's still doing the same kind of thing with Red, but the one thing that I like about this album, which you can download from iTunes and you can purchase wherever music is sold in your area, is the fact that it's a very different perception coming from Taylor Swift. It was a very different sound with one of the first singles from the album called We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together. The music video was viewed more times.